Hello students, today I am going to discuss about how the organism obtain their food. So the way of obtaining food is differ in various organism. Like in amoeba is a one cell organism, unicellular organism. So they absorb the food through the entire body surface. So pseudopodia is a finger like projection. It's come out through their body surface and helping the catching the food or prey. And when they catch the prey or food, so then the wall of the pseudopodia become fused and form a food vacuole, and then food vacuole go to the inner side of the organism body, and then complex food sustains break down into the simplest form, and then the simplest form then absorbed by the amoeba body, and undigested food it removed through the body surface. Same like in paramecium also. Paramecium having the cilia are present on the entire surface, and the cilia they are hair like projection, and they help in the movement of the food inside the body. They have paramecium having a specific food spot through which the food enters the body and then break down into the simplest form, and undigested food material removed from the body surface. So now here very important topic, that is nutrition in human beings. Human beings having well developed digestive system, and the digestive system of human beings, it is composed of alimentary canal and associated glands. So alimentary canal in human beings, it is a long tube like structure, and it starts with mouth and ends with anus. So students, first you need to know nutrition in human beings. So human beings having well developed digestive system. So well developed digestive system, and the parts of the digestive system that I am going to discuss here. First is the mouth, and second one is the buccal cavity. Then pharynx, then esophagus, then stomach. Is divided into three parts: cardiac, fundic, and pyloric. Next, intestine. Intestine also, there is two type of intestine: small intestine and large intestine. So first is the small intestine. Small intestine also having three parts: duodenum, jejunum, and ileum. Ileum is the highly quiet part of the small intestine, is known as ileum. Then large intestine. So large intestine, it is the also tubular part, and undigested waste material may come to the large intestine after breaking down of food. So large intestine having three parts: cecum, colon, and rectum. And last part of the alimentary canal is anus. So students, so there are various parts, various organs which constitute together and form the organ system. So mouth, you know, the opening of the both lips, the opening of upper and lower lip is known as mouth. Buccal cavity contains the several teeth. So there is a dental formula in human beings. So dental formula,
So 2 1 2 3 by 2 1 2 3 is the tensor formula. Number of tooth incisor, canine, premolar and molar. So incisor, canine, premolar and molar. So total there are 4 incisors in upper jaw and 2 canine and 4 premolar and 6 molar. So if we add all, so it will be 16 in upper jaw. Upper jaw contains 16 teeth and lower jaw contains 16 teeth. So total will be 32. An adult human being having 32 teeth and children having 2103 by 2103 is the dental formula of children. And it is a dental formula of adult human being. Adult human beings having 32 teeth. So 32 teeth means, so 16 teeth upper side and 16 teeth lower side. So here is the types of teeth. So teeth are 4 types. First is the incisor. Incisor is used to cut the food particle. Canine for tearing and for breaking into the small pieces, and premolar for crushing, and molar for mastication and chewing. So our logo this molar and premolar, they help in the mastication and chewing of the food into the small parts. So buccal cavity, they contain the singular is the tooth and plural is the teeth. So now pharynx is the common passage for food and air. So next is the esophagus. Esophagus is a tube like structure which help in the after the physical digestion. Food passes from the buccal cavity to the stomach through esophagus. The wall of the esophagus, they perform the peristalsis movement. Due to the peristalsis movement, the food enter inside stomach. Stomach is also divided into 3 parts: cardiac, thoracic, and pylori. Each and every part I will discuss through the diagram also. Intestine, there are 2 types of intestine on the basis of their thickness. So ABC the length. So length of the small intestine is 6 times greater than large intestine, but the large intestine, it is based only on the thickness. Thickness means it is broad. So and the small intestine, it is narrow, tube like structure. So that's why it is known as small intestine. Complete digestion of food takes place in the small intestine. So duodenum is the part which is attached to the stomach, that is duodenum. And jejunum is the J-shaped part of the small intestine, is jejunum. And ileum is the highly quiet central part of the intestine, is in the ileum. Now large intestine, on the basis of its thickness or broadness, so it is large intestine. A large intestine, cecum, colon and rectum. Large intestine, the function of the large intestine for the absorption of water and mineral which is present in the undigested food material, they are absorbed by the large intestine. So now students, see the parts. So mouth is the, it is the mouth, and here I am making buccal cavity. Pharynx is a portion, it is a common passage for food and air. So it is known as esophagus. Esophagus, it is also known as food pipe. The food passes to the stomach through esophagus. It is stomach. Stomach, it is the liver. So liver, it is the largest gland of the human body. The digestion of food, it depends on the bile juice. So it is known as gallbladder. Gallbladder. So gallbladder, hepatic cell, they are the unit of liver. And after the production of the bile juice, the bile juice is stored into the gallbladder. So gallbladder, sometime due to the gallstone, so gallbladder become removed from the body. So it is overall it is known as liver, and it is gallbladder. After the secretion of the bile juice is stored into the gallbladder, and when it is required, then it go to the duodenum portion through the common hepatopancreatic duct. It is pancreas. This portion is known as hepatopancreatic duct. Hepatopancreatic duct. Why it is known as hepatopancreatic duct? Because hepatic duct. One is the hepatic duct, second one is the pancreatic duct. Both duct, they join together, they means open together, hepatic duct. The duct which comes from the liver is known as hepatic duct. And the duct which comes from the pancreas known as pancreatic duct. Both duct open into the duodenum. That's why this duct is known as hepatopancreatic duct. It means the bile juice and pancreatic juice, both that poured into the duodenum. So this portion is known as hepatopancreatic duct. So after that, then this portion is known as duodenum. Duodenum, then jejunum. Then highly quiet portion is known as ileum. So this is known as appendix. Now there is no use of appendix in the human beings. There is no role of appendix in the digestion of food. So it is the vestigial organ. It was found in our ancestor. So it is a vestigial organ. So but the organs which are herbivore, they are having the appendix. Appendix, it help in the breaking down of cellulose. Cellulose is a complex carbohydrate. So this portion is known as anus. Rectum is the portion where undigested food material is stored. After that, they remove from the body. This is the colon portion. And it is the cecum. So students, now it is the overall structure of elementary canal along with associated gland. So total there are three glands are there. In the buccal cavity, there is one gland is known as salivary gland, and second is the liver, and third one is the pancreas. So there are three glands which are connected to the alimentary canal from the sideways. So first is the salivary gland, second is the liver, and third is the pancreas. So now, so next is the associated glands in the digestion of food. So now I think it is clear here. So now see the associated glands which help in the digestion, and what are the means the enzyme is this secrete enzyme or juices. So first is the associated glands. Associated glands means the glands which are connected to the alimentary canal, they are known as associated glands. So first is the salivary gland. Salivary gland, it releases enzyme that is known as salivary amylase. Salivary amylase is also known as thiamine. So second is the liver, and liver it secretes bile juice. So then what role of bile juice? It change the medium of the food. Change the medium of food means it break down the food. It change the food from acidic to basic medium. And third is the pancreatic juice. Pancreas having two types of gland. First is the exocrine gland, and second one is the endocrine gland. Exocrine gland, they release the enzyme which help in the digestion of food, and endocrine gland, they release the hormones. So there is no role of endocrine gland in the digestion of food, only exocrine gland they release enzymes, and endocrine gland they release hormones. So these hormones, they are chemicals, and it help in the increase or decrease the body metabolic activities. So now associated glands, three glands: salivary gland, which release the salivary amylase, that is known as thiamine, and liver, it release the bile juice. The function of the bile juice, it change the medium of the food, and pancreas have the exocrine gland of the pancreas. They release several enzymes, various enzymes are there. So next I will discuss about the digestion of food, how the food break down. So digestion of food, you know that breaking down of complex food nutrients into its simplest form by the various enzymatic action is known as digestion. So here you also know the digestion is completed into the two steps. First is the physical digestion, second is the chemical digestion. Physical digestion means the breaking down of food through the into the small pieces through the tooth and with the action of tongue. So tongue, it help in the replacing the food towards the molar and premolar. So after the physical digestion, then chemical digestion starts by the action of salivary amylase. So first now come to the digestion of food. So digestion of food, here we will discuss about the digestion of carbohydrate, digestion of protein, and digestion of fat. So because carbohydrate, protein, and fats are the complex food nutrients that break down into our alimentary canal. So first is the carbohydrate, digestion of carbohydrate. How the carbohydrate break down? So starch is the complex form of carbohydrate with the action of salivary amylase, it break down into the maltose. Maltose is the also carbohydrate. It is not a simplest carbohydrate. Carbohydrates are present in three forms. First is the monosaccharide, second one is the oligosaccharide, and third is the polysaccharide. So polysaccharide is the complex form of the carbohydrate. So starch is the example of polysaccharide, and when salivary amylase then it breaks down to the maltose. Second, so digestion of food in the mouth means in the buccal cavity only carbohydrate breaks down. After that, food passes to the stomach through the esophagus. Esophagus, so the wall of the stomach having the digestive cells. So digestive cells, they secrete the various juices like, so it occur in buccal cavity, now in mouth, now in stomach. So stomach having three type of cells, gastric cells, mucus cells, peptic cell, oxygenic cell. Mucus cells, they release the mucus. Oxygenic cells, peptic cells, they release the proenzyme pepsinogen. Proenzyme pepsinogen. And oxygenic cells, they release the HCl. HCl means hydrochloric acid. Due to the release of hydrochloric acid, so pyrosis or any kind of bacterial or infection that become neutralized. So we have three kinds of gastric cells. So first is the mucus cell, second is the peptic cells, third is the oxygenic cells. Now students, see how the proenzyme pepsinogen become active pepsin. So pepsin is an enzyme which released from the gastric cells, is break down the protein into proteases and peptones. So proenzyme pepsinogen in the stomach, the hydrochloric acid is released from the oxygenic cell of the stomach, which convert the proenzyme pepsinogen into the active pepsin. Active pepsin, it is inactive form. Inactive form means it cannot work. When HCl act like a catalyst here. So pepsin is the active form. Pepsin is the active form. Now pepsin will break down the protein. So protein will break down by the pepsin into proteases plus peptones. Proteases and peptones, it is also the secondary, means you can say secondary form of the protein, not a simplest form. So we have to study about breaking down food from the complex to its simplest form. So it starts in the complex, and maltose is the secondary form, not a simplest form. So it means we need to discuss more and more. So now in the stomach only protein breaks down. There is no breaking down of fat and carbohydrate into the stomach. Only protein breaks down into the proteases and peptones. But in the case of infants means small young ones. Small young ones till 6 months, they take milk only. Okay, so their elementary canal not functional. So there is one enzyme that is known as renin. Renin is the enzyme which break down the milk protein, that is casein, into calcium paracaseinate. Calcium paracaseinate is also known as curd. When the small children, they expel out their milk, so milk come out from their mouth in the coagulated form. Coagulated form means like curd, they expel out from their mouth.
So renin is the enzyme which break down the casein protein which present in the milk into calcium paracaseinate. So infants, elementary canals are not functional till 6 months. That's why the doctors, they suggest to the mother, do not provide any eatable item like chocolate and other domestic food items to the young ones till 6 months. Only milk, mother milk only. So next is the after breaking down of protein, then food passes to the duodenum. So students, hydrochloric acid is secreted from the objective cell of the objective cell of the gastric cell. They change the food into the acidic medium. Acidic medium means the food becomes sour in taste. Sometimes when we feel acidity, so then we feel acidity. So sometimes that when the people they eat food more, so then they feel heartburn disease. Actually, heart never burn. We cannot feel the burning of the heart, but it is commonly known as heartburn disease. When they eat more, then due to the acidity, so the acids they flow to the esophagus, to the food pipe, and they feel the burning sensation into the food pipe to the esophagus. But after taking water, they feel comfort. So that's why after taking spicy food, the people they eat more, drink, they demand more water. Why? Because they feel acidity also. So now, when the food comes to the duodenum. Duodenum means in the intestine. So complete digestion of food takes place in the small intestine. So liver release the bile juice, and you know that bile juice, it change the medium of the food. Medium of food means the foods in the stomach are in acidic medium, and when it reaches to the intestine, it becomes basic medium. Which medium? Basic medium. So bile juice contains no enzyme. Bile juice do not contain any enzyme, yet it is important for the digestion of food. Why? The reason is that it is used for there is big role of bile juice. It change the medium of the food. Then the lipase enzyme is come to the intestine and intestinal wall and pancreas. Then it fats can break down into the fatty acid and glycerol. Otherwise, it is not possible for the breaking down of fat into the fatty acid and glycerol. That's why bile juice is required for breaking down of for changing the medium of the food from acidic to basic. Then the lipase can work on the fats. So student, now you see here in mouth, in buccal cavity, the starch break down to the maltose. Stomach, in the inside the stomach, the first proenzyme pepsinogen by the action of acyl, it change into the pepsin. Active pepsin, now it becomes functional enzyme, and that pepsin break down the protein into the proteases and peptones. And in the intestine, liver secrete the bile juice through the hepatopancreatic duct, and it change the medium of the food. In the stomach, food become acidic medium, and in the intestine, it become basic medium when the bile juice added. So now you have seen that there is no breaking of fat. So that's fat in the stomach. So that's why when we eat that oily food like puri, paratha and such thing, we feel bulky more time. our stomach become full for more period of time. Why? Because digestion of fat is not possible in the stomach. No any enzymes are there which can break down the fat in the buccal cavity and in the stomach also. Now, first we will discuss about pancreas. So, pancreas released various enzymes. So, pancreas first is the trypsinogen, chymotrypsinogen. Chymotrypsinogen, procarboxy, peptidases, amylases, lipases, nucleases. These are the enzymes which release from the pancreas. Pancreas release the various enzymes. But these three enzymes, trypsinogen, chymotrypsinogen, procarboxypeptidases, they are also in the inactive form like proenzyme pepsinogen. So there is one more enzyme which released from the intestinal wall, that is known as enterokinase. Enterokinase is the enzyme which break down all these three enzymes into active form, and the active form is the trypsin, chymotrypsin, and next is the carboxy peptidases. Trypsin, chymotrypsin, carboxypeptidases. These are the enzymes. Now, first protein will break down. So, we have seen that protein was broken into proteases plus peptones in the proteases and peptones into the stomach. Now, it will break by these three enzymes. These three enzymes will break into dipeptides. Dipeptides. You know that protein is the polymer of amino acid. So now there is two amino acids which is known as dipeptides. And maltose or starch. By pancreatic amylase, it will break down into the maltose. Now 100% starch break down into the buccal cavity. The remaining starch break down by the pancreatic amylase. Lipase, so fats in the duodenum by the lipase enzyme break down the fat into monoglycerides plus diglycerides, and nucleic acid by nucleases which come through the pancreas, it break down into nucleosides plus nucleotides.
So pancreas release various enzymes. First is the trypsin, chymotrypsin. Carboxypeptidases, which break down the protein, proteases and peptones into dipeptides, and starch into maltose, and fat into by the lipase, it break down into the monoglyceride and diglyceride, and nucleic acid by the nucleases into the nucleosides and nucleotides. Now you should see the breaking down of food into the small intestine by intestinal juice. So now first dipeptides. Dipeptides is a protein, and dipeptidases is an enzyme which comes through the intestinal wall. Here I am writing here intestine. It's in small intestine. So into amino acids. And you know that amino acid is the simplest form of protein. So our definition was breaking down of complex food nutrients into the simplest form. So complex form of is the protein and simplest is the amino acid. Now digestion of protein completed here. Maltose by maltase enzyme into glucose plus fructose. Glucose and fructose is the simplest form of carbohydrate. Now that monoglycerides plus diglycerides by lipase, intestinal lipase. Pancreas also release lipase enzyme, intestinal wall also release the lipase enzyme. So it breaks down into the fatty acid and glycerol. Fatty acid plus glycerol. Fatty acid and glycerol is the simplest form of fat. Now nucleotides plus nucleosides by nucleosidases. Nucleosidases is an enzyme, and nucleotides and nucleosides, it is the nucleic acid. Now it breaks down into the bases plus salt. So now digestion of food completed here. So in the starting we discussed that the carbohydrate break down into the glucose plus fructose, and protein, simplest form of protein is the amino acid, and simplest form of fat is the fatty acid and plus glycerol. So students, so now your digestion of food is completed here. So breaking down of the carbohydrate into the glucose, protein to amino acid, and fat into the fatty acid and glycerol. So various enzymatic action I discussed with you all. If you have any question, you can ask query in your WhatsApp group. Thank you.